how did you get them alone?
Grooming. I would check out their family situation. I would check out their clothing to see how well they were, you know, financially. I would check out their social interaction with other kids. You know, when we were on the ballparks or on the gym floor, you know, I would make sure which ones I wanted to molest. I would give them special attention, congratulate them, talk to them when I know that I would never be allowed to talk to anybody else, you know, aside from everybody. I would give them the attention that an official is not supposed to give anybody. And it made them feel like, wow, he's paying me attention. An official is not supposed to give anybody, and it made them feel like, wow, he's paying me attention. You know, it is a direct form of grooming.
Were there certain characteristics that you looked for in children before molesting them?
In children, yes, but more I also looked at their families. If I thought the father was a threat, I would not approach the child. I would not approach the child. If I thought that the child had friends that he would tell, I would not approach him. If I thought the child had friends that were in the same capacity he was, I would approach him. For the simple fact that if I could molest him, I could lure him into believing, grooming him into believing that he would enjoy it. And therefore, I could manipulate him into having his other friends come and be molested by me as well.
So perhaps a child that doesn't really have a whole lot of friends, maybe not really a strong family, things like that.
Yes, no spiritual values. Weak in education, you know, needs help in many ways, even from split parenting, you know, has a mother who may be having problems with the family, you know, well, here comes superhero in to help out, you know, wow, well, thank you very much, no problem, you ever need me to take him away for the night so you can have a night out, no problem, it works.